And I decided to change my life. I did really 3 months, 10 minutes every day twice I did it mechanically. Okay. I'm telling you now, honestly. I didn't know what is the meaning of meditation. Somebody said technique, do it. Just follow the technique. I know what happened to me now. The memory got enhanced. Okay. Concentration got enhanced. In the 10th standard, first examination itself, I got 10th standard in mind. That is the first miracle that happened in my life, okay? And from then onwards, I never left meditation, okay? Thanks to all the seven masters, okay? Mahesh Yogi, though I not met him, but his meditation, I entered the world of spirituality. Ramakrishna Ashram was very near to our place, that is the National College, Basavanagudi. I was going regularly. Somewhere that Ramakrishna Ashram attracted me. And the words of Vivekananda really made an impact. Rise, awake, don't stop till your goal is reached. Okay? A man without a goal is like a ship without a rudder. So all these things give me a josh. Yes, he is a master. Great masters. And in 1987, I met Sukhabodhananji. How many people know about Sukhabodhananji? Yeah. With him, I was there for 10 years, solidly. Okay. Like one-to-one, we have worked. And he started his program called Life Program. Okay. And Jayanti and all used to stay in the same Malleshwaram area, okay? And we had a very good time. And his four gurus were Chinmayananda. He opted out of Chinmaya Mission. Dayanand Saraswati, J. Krishnamurti and Osho. And 90% of his meditations were on Osho, okay? And what is the fact about Osho is, in Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, there is 108 methods of meditation. Okay? Yoga Nidra, Kundalini, all that. Looking at a candle, it is a meditation called Trataka. These are all different kind of meditation which is there in the Vijnana Bhairava Tantra. Osho divides it to some more. He's starting with dynamic meditation, for those who know about it. And like that he made so many. He was more of a psychotherapist, Osho. And I got initiated under Osho order in 1989. You will be surprised. After the graduation, instead of searching for a job, I went behind Sukhabodhananji and Osho. And just think, if you are in that position, you would have told you are a gone case. Instead of earning money, making a living and making a career, I was very reluctant to work. But afterwards it got stabilized, that's a different story. I worked with Sukhabodhananji up to 88, 98. And then I formed an organization called Team Winners and Zen Meditation Center, RKR Road, where we are functioning for last 10 years. And in 2005, I met Patriji, Subhash Patriji, the founder of Pyramid Movement. You must have heard him, you must have seen him. He built one of the biggest pyramids in Asia on Kharagpura Road. And when I met him first time, I don't know, the instant chemistry. Maybe I was waiting for a master like him, where he really removed all my incompletions and imperfections, here cut and paste, here and there, and gave me a lot of responsibilities. I was a frog in a well, but he saw me that you have a heart of a whale, you can work with sharks, you can play with the dolphins in the sea, and there I am here, after 8 years, with working with seven masters. Then I I head the publicity, that is Prachara Trust, that is Pyramid Dhyan Prachara Trust. It is one of the biggest pyramid in Asia on Kalakpura Road from Banchakri Temple. It's about 30 kilometers, after art of living 12 kilometers. And thousands of visitors, meditators come there. On full moon day, there will be a whole night meditation. Meditation is given free. Food is given free. Only accommodation, they charge very little. So, I head that prachar all over Karnataka. And after I did my management, I did a lot of work with my own self, improving my communication skills and public speaking and all. Then I started working with different models. Okay, as she mentioned, she asked me what to speak. I thought leaving your footprints should be fine. Leaving your footprints means what? After we go, people should remember you for good things or bad things. So that is the... In Maslow's theory of hierarchy, there is something called the bottom needs called as roti, kapda, makan, basic needs. Next he talks of security needs. Then he talks of recognition. Then he talks of name, fame, higher knowledge, higher achievement. Then lastly, at the tip of the triangle is self-actualization. Stephen Covey corrected it beautifully. We have four L's. One L is called living, learning. First is learn to live. Then learn. Learning itself is one thing, okay? And loving, connect with people. Connect with fellow beings, connect with family members, connect with society, connect with your team. And lastly is the tip again talks of leaving a legacy behind. What is the legacy behind your living? So I just change according to the current times. Like we make a living, we learn, achieve something. Then we love people, we connect, then we talk of leaving a legacy. I am going to talk on the leaving a legacy. You are reached the age where you have must have definitely left a huge legacy behind you. Okay? But still there is a remaining time. If at all we can do something about life, then why not? Okay? Why not we leave behind the footprints, okay? Not just for until 20 years where photo is kept in the living room. After the sun is, you have kicked the bucket. For 20 years your photo is there on the living room. Until that sun is alive, that photo will go to bedroom, and the bedroom will go to the loft, then it will go to the tipe, okay? Thus then. I'm sorry to say, I'm being blunt. This is what happening. Okay? Please, do it. We think that whatever we have left behind, the properties, cars, whatever it is, will come behind us. Unfortunately, it's a big no. It may come up to a certain limit. Okay? It is not. Whatever good deeds you have left behind, whatever good shishyas you left behind, what contribution you have left behind, okay, is going to make a lot of difference. You may say, why should we worry about world? I am happy. That's the limitation you are only creating. Okay, you want to become a frog in a well? You want to have the consciousness of a frog in a well? Or you want to be the see the beauty of ocean? Still there is time to see the beauty of ocean. I was talking to sir, body, the age only is to body. It is not for the soul, not for the mind, not for the heart. You are still young at heart. You can be young at heart. What do you say? Yes or no?
Yes.
I want a big yes.
Yes.
Let us clap for that, okay? Big clap, because clapping has got in the other element. Please clap. Become a child. Louder, please. Madam, you are clapping. Clap for your own self. Clap for your own self. We never recognize ourselves. Always trying to live for others. Your way. Let us see a meaning for our life. Still, whatever time is left, let us not look through our children. We do have our own life. We, from womb to tomb, we are donors. We may connect in the journey, connect with your husband, connect with your wife, connect with your children, with your friends, legacy behind, all connect. But when you come to this world, you come alone. When you go alone. Nobody comes with you. That Sati Yuga is over. When husband died, you know. Now he says, whatever he died, he becomes his age. I'll stay for some more time. So, I would like to start tell a story. One old lady, okay, was planting a sampling on the roads and putting water. A young man saw it. He asked, "Madam, what are you doing? I'm putting a sampling. Will you be alive to see the shade and able to eat fruits of this tree?" She said, "No." "Then why you are stuck?" "If somebody had done it 10 years back, I would have enjoyed the shade and I would have had the fruit. I am not putting the sampling for myself, I am putting for future generation to enjoy." Friends, we eat fruits, the coconut, mangoes. You don't know who has put it. Okay? In the same way, George Bernard Shaw said beautifully, okay? Life is not a candle, small candle. It's a torch. Okay? I am holding it for the moment. I'll make it burn as brightly as possible for the future generation till I hand it over. Okay? And as long as the torch is with you, make it bright. Let it burn. As brightly as possible. So we give to the younger generation, they will take the torch forward. If you ask me what I'll get if I leave the legacy behind, I'll talk about the people who have legacy behind. When you talk of idealism, we talk of Sri Rama, Maryada Purushottama, okay? He was called as, Mathur Krishnamurti used to tell beautifully, he was called as Purav Hashi. Whoever he used to meet used to say, "Namaste," to the divinity. Purva Bhashi means you open a conversation with whoever you met. Namaste. Maryada Purushottama. He has left a huge legacy behind. Sri Krishna, okay? He may not be an idealist like Rama. He got. But he left behind the art of living. Not this art of living. Long. This is a commercial art. Art of living. Badukuva Kale. Helikutta Sri Krishna. Vapari. Buddha came 2500 years back. He said, "Be a light unto yourself. Ninnage neene belakagu." Udare Udare Atma, Sri Krishna said. If you see, look at Jesus' photo, you see only love and compassion. If you look at Shirdi Sai Baba photo, you only see love, compassion. You just connect. If you go to Shirdi and just sit there, you just started crying. I don't know for whatever reason.